Caroline's father owned a second-hand shop, and she loved to wander around looking at the old furniture. One day, an old lady bought a butterbox full of old books into the auction. When no one was around, Caroline opened the box to look at the books. She took them out one by one. As her hand reached down to the bottom of the box, she felt something rattle. There in the bottom of the box was a pile of old glasses tied together with a blue ribbon. Caroline tried on each pair of glasses. Some had gemstones around them. Some had barely lenses when you looked through them. And some that so strong they hurt your eyes. One pair were child's eyes. Caroline tried them on. She was amazed. Everything looked so detailed and colorful. These were magic glasses. Caroline put them in her pocket and went up to her cubbyhole. The next day was auction day, and Caroline was in her cubbyhole. The butterbox was slot 94. Caroline saw a strange-looking man bidding for it. He had pointy ears and eyes the color of blood, and beside him stood his son. They were Grimbles. They won the butterbox and quickly took it outside. Caroline followed them. She saw them pulling out the book, but when they realized the glasses were not there, they ranted and yelled at each other. Caroline hid the magic glasses in her hut. She had to take them to Botanical Hill at 12 o'clock and pass them to Moon Girl, who will use them to fight an invisible dragon and save the world around the corner from the Grimbles. A beetle took a rat who told the Grimble cat that the glasses were in Caroline's hut. The Grimbles raced to the hut and arrived just as Caroline took the glasses from behind her. The Grimbles chased Caroline. She jumped into the river with a magic glasses on. At 12 o'clock, Caroline arrived at the top of Botanical Hill, ready to give Moon Girl the magic glasses. There was no sign of Moon Girl. Was she too late? She sat down on the seat and waited. Suddenly, she felt a tap on her shoulder, and when she turned, there stood Moon Girl. Caroline gave her the glasses. "Thank you," said Moon Girl. "You have been a great help. Good luck in your battle with the dragon," said Caroline. "We're not going to tell you if Moon Girl wins the battle with the dragon. You'll have to read the book to find out."